Let's face it, erectile function is threatened by the aging process. In the Massachusetts male aging study, 40% had problems at the age of 40 and 70% at the age of 70. This is not complete erectile dysfunction, but erectile difficulties in developing and or maintaining an erection that is satisfactory for sexual activity. My name is Stefan Buntrock. I'm a board-certified urologist and sexologist. And in this video, I am giving you 5 tips to help you to keep your erections a few years longer. Number 1 is nighttime and morning erections. Many men are not aware that these two belong together. For proper erectile function, nighttime erections are indispensable. Therefore, you should sleep 7 to 8 hours per night, avoid alcohol and caffeine before bedtime, and keep a routine where you prepare yourself to go to sleep. Sleep apnea and frequent urination at night will disturb your sleep and interfere with nighttime erections. So if this is something you recognize, let your local doctor sort it out. Erectile dysfunction usually starts very slowly and develops over the course of several years. If you have slight problems already, a low dose of a PDE5 inhibitor at bedtime will restore nighttime erections and help your penis to recover. Tip number 2 concerns testosterone. Late onset hypogonadism is a frequent condition in men over 50. Low testosterone will cause structural changes within the muscular architecture of the cavernous bodies, and this could result in a venous leak. What is low testosterone? Generally, anything below 8 nanomoles per liter. Your personal testosterone level can be checked with a simple blood test. It is also possible to measure testosterone in the saliva, but that's not my favorite method. The measurement has to be made before 11 a.m., and if it shows a deficiency, it is important to repeat the test at least once on another day before a diagnosis can be made. Hypogonadism can be treated by testosterone replacement therapy. The principle is to get testosterone in the low to normal range, something between 12 to 15 nanomoles per liter. Can you increase your testosterone yourself? I would say, if you are overweight or obese, there's a real chance if you lose weight, because body fat converts testosterone to estrogen. Less fat means less estrogen. But if you have a normal body weight, it is not possible to increase testosterone by working out, at least regarding a permanent increase. Tip number 3 is short. Monitor your blood pressure on a regular basis. Hypertension is one of the major destroyers of erections. Measure it on several occasions throughout the day because it changes. Resting blood pressure, that's when you wake up in the morning and still lay in bed, should be around 120 over 80. Tip number 4 is very important. Never smoke. Or stop smoking immediately if you are a smoker. Smoking will lead to erectile dysfunction in most sooner or later. Tip number 5 is about food. Be careful what you eat. The more industrialized your meals are, the more inflammation they will cause in your body. Keep a diet high in vegetables and legumes and fish instead of meat. General inflammation of the body is unavoidable with age, but it can be aggravated by the wrong food. Inflammation will block the release of nitric oxide, and without this gas, the penis will not erect. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.